And if I wanted to hold out for 300, I'd probably get it, but I'm not that concerned about that.
Because they only made so many of those.
I really want to move the Danbury Mint shit off the shelf very quickly because I know it's deteriorating. I know it's only going to get worse as time goes on.
After Christine goes, how many more are left?
Oh, only two or three. And I'm not going to sell those because they're the cheapies. You know, or they're like my Model 8 models. I'm going to keep those ones because I have the car. Then my little Model T, I'm keeping that, you know, that stuff. But those are not expensive models. Christine is the last of the really expensive ones. Because the movie cars were all expensive models and shit.
Yeah.
Because they were all limited, so that's the good money
ones. Yeah, the 18 van or the Chips motorcycle or whatever.
Yeah, the wreckers, trucks and shit like that, like the one I just sent to Israel. And
how much of the Budweiser horse in the case?
That one was not much, like $40. Because it had gotten damaged, water damaged out there in the shed. And it just wasn't that popular a model, I guess.
And you said you got no Franklin Mint stuff, right?
Never had any Franklin Mint stuff.
Kind of a shame to see it go, though.
What?
The Christine car, it's kind of cool.
It is, but I could always get another. Yeah. Problem is that Danbury Mint made them cheaply. They use crappy, not them, but their suppliers in China use crappy fucking pop metal. Hmm. Which is really a shame and inexcusable in so expensive a model.
Hmm.
I know what's. I've seen evidence on other ones. I know what's happening. It's starting to break down.
So does the doors open on that one?
Yes. Oh, everything opens.
The wheels. The
steering. Oh yeah. It doesn't have the tinted windows though.
They had a half hour special on that car.
Yeah.
It's in California. It's on display.
There are actually more movie correct models out there of Christine than the one that Danbury Mint made.
Hmm.
Ones with the tinted windows and all the other shit.
Yeah.
Green LEDs in a dashboard. So it, you know, glows really bright and shit like that. I still have three or four for sale on there. Lesser expensive models. They're not so expensive, but once they're gone, that'll be it. I'll keep the four or five I have left, and that's it. You know, if they fall apart, I'm not really that concerned about it. I think I still have the 42 Town and Country Chrysler, because I like that one.
Hmm.
The 58 Edsel.
What color is the Edsel?
It's a Bermuda, so it's red and white.
Hmm.
Or orange or white, I forget which. And they got two Model A's, one Model T model.
Three years of the Edsel, right? Or two?
58, 59, and 60.
Yeah, 3 years.
Yeah. Yeah.
My favorite episode of The Munsters is where he picked up that red ruby and was to put a curse on things. When was the last time you used this? You ever hear of the Edsel?
Yeah.
That's fucked up.
Yeah. Well, Edsel had the misfortune to be introduced at a time when we were in a mini recession, you know, and sales slumped across the board. And it was really a little too similar to the Ford models in many ways. You know, the Edsel just had more gimmicks on it, which really weren't needed.
Fully restored, in condition. What's an Edsel?
Oh, I don't even know. 20, 30 grand probably, tops, maximum.
Convertible, mint condition.
It would have to be something, yeah. Something like the Bermuda wagon, you know, that's really, really rare.
Hmm.
Yeah, they had the same basic big V8s the Fords had. Automatic transmissions weren't that different, you know. Except they had bullshit like that push button electric shift crap, which of course, being electric, was always fucking up. And they did away with a lot of that shit by 1960.
Because it was all, the car was a lemon, right?
No, well, the 58s were because of the goddamn electronic crap. Is there something in the road up there? But I saw eyes.
Hmm.
You know, they had an automatic lubrication system for the front end, which really didn't work very well. You know, it was prone to problems, especially over time.
You got two or three in the yard, right?
I have four, actually. I have three 58s and a 59.
Would have loved to have seen them when they came in.
Actually, they were all wrecked.
Yeah?
Every one of them, yes, they were. They were crashed.
But in nice shape, though, but
they
wrecked.
They probably were, yeah, but wrecked. I mean, I'm selling quite a few parts off these cars now.
Hmm.
But I noticed that by the 59 that we have, it's basically just a Ford. You know, they got away from that stupid push-button shifter and went to a regular column shift.
Plymouth had the push button.
Well, Plymouth had a mechanical push button. Ford had an electric one with a servo motor down underneath not the dash, but under the floorboard that electrically shifted the transmission when you push buttons in the center of the steering wheel. So you know that was prone to problems. I mean, especially in that era. They just didn't have the technology to make that work right. Well, even today, it would be problematic. And they were. And that did not help Edsel sales either.
You don't see a whole hell of a lot of those in car shows.
No, they're fairly rare. But they are around. They're out there. There's a whole club for those cars. And of course, they were also prone to rust, especially here in the Northeast, which is why you don't see that many around here.
Rusticle?
Oh, yeah. All of the cars were of that era. It didn't matter if it was a Ford or Chevy or, you know, especially Dodge or whatever. Yeah. It was all rotted. Yeah, I know a kid in Texas, he's got a 59, I believe it is, sedan, V8. Car's rust-free, and he got it for, like, I don't know, $1,200 or some shit. He's got to run it and drive it. Just needs a lot of little shit.
Park in the living room.
He's got that. He's got a 56 Cadillac. That he also picked up pretty cheap, which is pretty rust-free. He has a rust hole in the floor of that one, but it's not too bad.
If you ever watch Game Show Network, I was watching that from the early 70s, and you get the lemon there, door number one or door number two. And you will get a Cadillac, and then they show us a primer that looked like about a 56 or a 57, but it was all there, and I'm getting and everybody's like, wah, wah, you know, to get the mule
I'll
or
take
something.
It, yeah.
Yeah, you know, I'm thinking, oh my God, if you had that car right now in that condition.
Yeah. Prize guy took his car home, stuck in the garage, didn't touch it for 40 years, now he's got the last laugh.
You know?
Yeah, the 71 brand new model is rusted away somewhere, and I got this 56, they gotta pay me $50,000 for it, whatever.
Yeah, you know. It was on like a week ago, and I'm going, oh yeah, I'll take the movie prize.
Yeah, no problem. Tow truck will be here in an hour.
Motor of Noma, yeah, you know. They want like a toast or something, and they're jumping up and down, and... Well, here it is, 1973, 1974. That's a big deal, you know?
Yeah,
My mom said we had nothing, you know, in back in them days. Just about had a toaster and a built-in oven in the house.
Well, there was a recession going on in those years. It was, you know, kind of tight. Well, cars were not expensive back then. You know, even adjusted for inflation, they weren't expensive. You could buy a pretty decent running used car for $75. You know? Even $50 sometimes. And $25 is not unheard of. The things like Volkswagen Bugs and things like that, you know. Rusty but running. And even in today's money, that's only a few hundred more. You know, it's not that much. Well, today, anything that you can actually get inspected is going to cost you $1,200 to $1,500, bare minimum, you know? For a Honda Accord or something like that from the mid-90s, you know, and older, but rusty, but runs and passes inspection there. Scrapes by. But I remember back then buying, you know, like mid-60s to early 70s Chevys and Fords and whatnot, and they were like 150, 75. They weren't like nothing. Yeah, they might have smoked a little bit. Maybe the brakes made a squealy noise. Might have needed a muffler, but all little shit. Would change their cars and they change their fucking socks. Sometimes more frequently than I think. I think it's all lit up over there.
Oh yeah. When did the lights come on?
Oh, about a week ago. Oh, he's had power for a while, but they just finished the wiring in the outside lights.
We got cameras up there, so assholes don't go in there.
Oh, he has cameras on the building now. Yeah.
Good.
That's the reason for the lights.
Wait for some asshole to go in there.
Yep. Waiting for the generator thieves to come back. Yep. Start pilfering this shit again.
Oh, I'll keep you posted on Erie.
Yep.
That won't be for a couple of 3 weeks.
Yeah, well, that's the end of the month. We're only
that's pretty much by the end of the month, so yeah.
We're on the 10th now, so.
I will keep you posted.
All right, Scott. Get that box and shit out of there. And that's that.